I'm Marcel Beugelsdijk from the Netherlands, owner of Bemint and specialized in Power Query. This is one of the videos in a series about various topics in Power Query and all share the same element being a function, a value type in Power Query. This video is about reading files from a folder. In this folder, I have all Excel workbooks with clock switches in all Windows time zones, and I want to combine these in one large table. I have a blank Power BI desktop file, so I choose files from a folder, connect, OK, edit. I only need the files that start with parentheses UTC. Okay, now we're done. And now the magic trick starts. Combine files in Power Query. My data is in datetime table 1 in each of the files. Okay. Several queries are created to import the files from the folder and transform these files in tables and combine those tables into one large table. That's basically what's happening. One issue is that the naming of the query objects is a bit unfortunate. So the first thing I will do is rename the query objects. One of the objects is a sample file, which is the first file in my folder. So that's okay. This is a parameter that is pointing to a sample file in this case, but actually it represents the file contents. So let's rename that to file contents. In this query, a sample file is transformed, which is the example query for the function underneath. So in the end, the result of this query is a sample table. And let's rename this function to transform file. I remove the spaces so there is clear naming convention in Power Query. In the sample table query, there is a navigation to the correct table we require. And otherwise, there is no data typing. In earlier versions of the combine binaries functionality, I'm pretty sure there was data typing in the sample file. So let's reintroduce that and choose transform detect data type. And now I have all datetime values, which is the correct data type. So now I have the correct data types in my sample file. If you go to the main query, with combined binaries, there are 5 steps added to the function. This was just before we pressed combined binaries. And then invoke custom function, which is actually the transform file. And this is a function automatically created from the query sample file. So I added the change type, and in this function, if I go into the advanced editor, you will see that also your change type is added to the function. So anything you do in the sample table will be promoted into the function, and in the main query, that function is invoked. So it will give you a table with typed values in this case. Also, the naming of this column is a bit unfortunate. So I will just rename it to datetime tables in my case, because that is what it is. Let's copy this so we can correct the other steps. This one is okay. So now it is working, but something terrible has happened with combined binaries. I already explained that in the past There was a typing step of the sample file. In later versions of the combined binary functionality, that typing step was removed, and instead the typing is done as an additional step in the main query. Over here, the value types are still any. And to have that corrected again, a change type step is added. I think this is not a very good solution. I think it's good if the typing is done in the sample table query, like we did. And when the custom function is invoked, then the new column has now type any, but now we can use the function value type and using the type of the sample table. So we get all column names and column types from the sample table, which is then applied to this column, date timetables. Meaning that as soon as this column is expanded, that all the columns will have the correct data type already. So we don't need this step anymore. So as a wrap-up, when choosing combined binaries, a set of query objects is created. If you want to better understand what these queries are doing, then you can rename the queries. So we have a sample file binary, a parameter that is pointing to file contents. There is a sample table, which is the transformation of the sample file into a Power Query table. And a function transform file that transforms a file into a Power Query table. So in the main query, it looks like this. The invoke custom function is just the each transform file content with the value type of the sample table, meaning that all the columns in this table have the correct names and types. So when the table is expanded in the end, the columns already have the correct data type, date time in this example, and there is no additional change type step required anymore. So far this video, thanks for watching. See you in the next video in which the function value type will be used.